I have made a that is going to sustain you to the end of the scarcity. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I have provided a helper, a sustainer for you. Go there, you will see the woman, and the woman will sustain you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the Bible says, Elijah went, and as he entered the gate of heaven, in the first month, he met the woman, and the woman was gathered sticky in order to do what? To prepare food. And this is happening in the period of scarcity. And the woman had only one oil for a meal. Just only for one time. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He looks on her. How can God, a window that does not have anything, and only have only one time oil for a meal? Stay here. She is a helper to somebody. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
That will make you understand. It's not he who have abundance. God can put something now.
Yes, sir.
Into your hand.
Yes,
and not only he put it into your hand, even you become a helper to another person.
Yes,
can somebody come to revelation?
Yes, sir.
Can you come to revelation?
Yes, sir.
The Bible says the woman was a widow. And what can a widow have? A widow have no anything. And the Bible says she had only a bottle of oil for a meal, just only for one time. It means the woman has nothing. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
She has nothing, but yet she is a helper.
Yes,
not somebody.
Yes, helper to me.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yet she is a
helper.
How does it work? God made the provision. Praise the Lord. The woman was an instrument. Are you with me? The woman was an instrument. God is the one that do all that provide. And God knows how to provide. Is someone with me? The only thing you need to pray now is to carry the revelation to get in contact with that right helper. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
To get in contact with that right helper. I thank God that you have fasted 7 days and prayed.
Yes, sir.
And this service today is going to mark the beginning of the manifestation of your blessings. That is why the theme of this service says, victory is mine. Say, victory is mine. Say, victory is mine.
Victory is mine.
Say, my father, my father.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
You need to do what?
Pray.
That area is another department.
Yes, sir.
Now, this is prayer.
Session.
Prayer session. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Actually, every service you render to God, that will have a special
reward.
Have a special reward. Then you must use your mouth to pray. Reward. To tell God what to do. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Then the Bible says the woman had only one oil. Did the oil finish?
No.
Did it finish?
No.
The oil didn't finish. The small oil lasted many months, many days.
Yeah, the red oil.
Praise the Lord. I didn't say red oil. Hallelujah. Now, you want to pray. There is a little thing that remains with you. There are people here. What is in your account is just a little.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But here's something here. That little can multiply. Hey, hey, hey. I said that little can multiply. Hey, hey. That little can increase.
Hey, hey.
That little can increase.
Hey, hey.
Do you believe that?
Yes, sir. Sir,
somebody hearing this prophetic
word.
Decreasing every month. There are people here, you call money even to pay rent. Am I speaking the truth? Now, you have 1 million in account. You have 1,000 in account. Or you have 500 in account. But every day, the thing is what? Reducing. It's reducing. But I am here by the oil of God upon my life. Whatever that causes you to reduce, whether in finance, whether in other means and other ways, by the oil of God upon my life, that power that is causing you to reduce in every side of your life, I destroy that power. You shall not reduce again. You shall not reduce again. You shall not reduce again. Holy Spirit, come. I'm going to pray for you. I'm going to pray for you. You will not fall into trouble.
Amen.
Just now, I see an arrow flying in your face. That the arrow that is flying and targeting you, especially in this month of September, that arrow shall revive back to the center.
Amen.
And the arrow is to divide. The Bible says that God who made you, he said you shall not be devoured.
Amen.
For he is with you and he uphold you with his righteous hand.
Amen.
Lift up Jesus. Father, you say, let that arrow that fly by the day, but by the night, shall harm your children. I pray for your son. And I ask you, Lord, the arrows of the wicked, may you return back to the
Savior.
Father, I decree, by your divine power, I ask, set him free.
Amen.
Anyway, you have been marked for Deborah, I challenge that mark.
Amen.
I raise the mark.
Amen.
I raise the mark.
Amen.
And I mark you by the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
You are marked for success.
Amen.
You are marked to live and celebrate.
Amen.
Father, thank you,
Jesus.
This season, whatever that sent to make you cry, I turn them into celebration.
Amen.
The enemy is disappointed.
Amen.
They are disappointed.
Amen.
They are disappointed.
Amen.
Job said, the Lord disappoint the handwork of a crafty. Say, if the Lord weapon against the children of God, that their hand cannot perform it. I pray the hand they are using to hold the arrow and the weapons, may that hand be paralyzed. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you,
you are free.
Amen.
You are free.
Amen.
You are free.
Amen.
I discourage you from a friend that will bring problem into your life.
Amen.
And that is this arrow. Yes, Lord. Book of Isaiah, chapter 7, verse 7. When the Syria, the king of Syria, and the army of Syria, when they send a message to Judah, to devour Judah, and the Lord revealed to the prophet, Prophet Isaiah, he said, go and tell Judah that God says the Lord, that he shall not
happen.
And as it is, according to the word of God, it shall not happen.
Amen.
You are faithful in this month.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now we're going to declare prophetic declaration. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are going to say to Satan, enough
is enough.
Enough
is enough.
Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Listen, your hand on your head. Say, my father, my father.
My father.
As I begin to declare.
As I begin to declare.
The harassment of devil.
Every harassment of
the witches and wizards.
Every harassment
of demons.
Jesus.
me tell you, even though God said after you pray, you need to be patient. Patient helps it. Hallelujah.
Yeah,
there is a time limit for patience. Are you with me?
Yes.
You can plant a crop 1 year, no harvest, no germination. Did you? 2 years, nothing. 3 years, nothing. It's not of God. It's not of God. Ecclesiastes 3, it says everything has been appointed according to season. It is season by season. It says everything has season. There is a season to sow, there is a season to reap. There is a season to pray, and a season of manifestation. Somebody is about to manifest. Since over a year, you put the money to pay rent. You put the money, you ask, you pay. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Don't you be a lender. Only a borrower. The Bible says you shall lend, you shall know.
Borrow.
Am I the one that said it? He said you shall be at the head, you shall not be. He said you shall be above. Your life in worship. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You know, ask your life, is that what God says? Say, my father, my father. Every cause of delay in my life.
Every cause of delay in my life.
People that kept me in wilderness.
Yeah.
You shall take up a journey to your destiny. In the name of Jesus.
fire.
Amen.
Between now until the ending of this year, you are covered with water fire.
Yeah.
Your families are covered with water fire.
Amen.
Your families are covered with water fire.
Amen.
You are covered with water fire.
Amen.
You are covered with water fire.
Amen.
Every witchcraft that are waiting for the meat, by the fire of the Holy Ghost, may angel that carries water fire visit them.
Amen.
May they visit them. Every witch in your village that are waiting for your doctor, may the sword of the angel visit them. In the name of Jesus,
amen.
I release the angel that fight for you.
Amen.
They will fight for you.
Amen.
As the Lord promised, I will fight for you.
Amen.
In the book of Exodus 13:14, he told the children of Israel, he said, I will fight for you.
Amen.
He said, the enemy that you see them no more.
Amen.
I pray for you, the Lord will fight for you.
Amen.
My birthday. Lord, I want to give them a birthday gift.
Amen.
I want to give them a birthday gift.
Amen.
I'm celebrating my birthday next Sunday, but today begins.
Amen.
I pray this week as many that are under the roof of this place. My guardian angel begin to distribute grace to them, favor to them, miracle to them, blessing to them. In the name of Jesus, Father, the one I ask, as many that are here this week, give all of them money. Give them money. Give them money. Your hand shall carry money. If you believe it?
Yes.
If somebody believe this,
yes, sir.
If you believe it, let go of the past. Let go of the former things. Because there are the things that are weighing you down. Lamentation 3, verse 21 to 23. He said, these I recall to my mind. Therefore, I have hope. Verse 22. He said, it is of the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed because his compassion failed not. Verse 23. He said, they are new. He said, his compassion, his mercy, his faithfulness, they are new every morning. Great is our
faithfulness.
The blessings of God, they are new every morning. They are new all the time. God desire to do a new thing in your life. As you wake up new day, every new day carry new blessing and new testimony. But people don't know the revelation. That is why the first thing you do before you sleep, pray. When you wake up in the morning, speak blessing into your life. Because God has prepared a new thing to do in your life. New day, new blessing. New hour, new blessing. New section of the day, new blessing. People are still thinking about the business of yesterday. People are still thinking the business of last year. People are still thinking, they are still holding things on the path. They don't think about things that is new. Things in your front. From the things that unseen, you can see them, but truly there is something. There is something. But the agenda of God for you is to do a new thing every day, new blessings, and that is why you should expect new blessings every day and all the time. If God gave you favor yesterday, that's for yesterday. Today has its own favor. Tomorrow has its end. People are still living with a past glory. The glory of God is new every moment and every day. And that's the presence of God. Always expect every day and all the time. God, let new thing happen. Let new thing happen. Let new thing happen. Even though it has happened before, let new thing happen. And when you begin to dwell in the past glory, you become a bondage. You close the door for the new. You close the door for the new. Somebody give me money yesterday. Hey! Favor has come. Money, favor of yesterday. That is what you are depending on throughout the whole week or the whole month. You get some money, and that money that you get, until that money finish, you will not look for money again. Living with past glory. Living with past glory. You don't expect me. You say, behold, I am doing a new thing. I am prophesying to your life. After this message, new things begin to happen in your life. I said, new things begin to happen in your life. Keys that will help you to experience new beginning. Concentrate. Keys that will help you to experience new beginning of separate. Keys that will help you to experience a new beginning of settlement. Number one, you must have a genuine confession and repentance. Genuine confession and what?
Repentance.
As I said before, you cannot calculate a new wine and add it to an old tattoo. That is why the Bible said in the book of Isaiah chapter 59, he said, it's not heavy, never my hands is short, that it cannot hear your prayer, or it cannot bless. He said, behold, your iniquity has all separated us. Something has separated us. Sin has separated you and God. So if you are expecting or desiring, experiencing new beginning, you must confess. You must make on a daily basis confession and repentance. Thank God. Jesus has paved the way. He has made way for you. All you need to do, just open your mouth. Just make a confession. Just make a confession. First John chapter 1 verse 9. He said, if we confess our sins, he said, God is faithful and he just forgives our sins and cleanses us from all unrighteousness. He is faithful to forgive us and to cleanse us from all iniquities. All you need to do, confess your sins. If you are a man who is proud, don't be proud before sin or before God. Let it be your daily basis activities, confession, repenting. Watch the life of David. All his prayer is all about returning back to God. Returning back to God. Because why? You can sin against, you are sinning against God 24 hours. If you cannot sin against God with your ear, you sin against God with your eyes. With your thought. What you think? Praise the Lord. What you see in internet. What you watch in internet. Very easy for you to sin against God. You watch naked photos in internet. You watch pornography. What to sin, you sin against God through your eyes and through your spirit. You open your ear and begin to hear bad things. People begin to speak and cancel you wrongly. You sin against God. People don't know when you listen to a voice of Satan. Because anything you listen to, you assimilate it and you create a vacuum in your spirit. You have sinned against God. Hallelujah. That's why be careful of what you listen to. Be careful of who you listen to. You can be initiated, you can be perverted through a voice, through what you hear, through a message that you are listening. Your spirit can immediately be perverted. Now let me tell you now, no physical, we are living in a demonic digital world. Demonic initiation digital world. You can be initiated through internet. Somebody with me?
Yes, sir.
Anything you want to belong, you can be initiated through internet. You can be initiated through listening. Because it's a spirit. As you listen, you open door for the spirit. And the spirit will enter into the room. And your room is your heart. And it begins to dwell there. And it begins the activity of devil and darkness. So be careful of what you listen to. Be careful of what you hear. Be careful of what you see. And because of all, because of our eyes, our ear, our tongue, you must make confession regularly. All the time, you must confess your sin. In the book of Leviticus, chapter 5, verse 1, I said, it shall be when he is guilty in any of these matters that he shall confess that he has sinned in that thing. When he comes to sin, don't prove pride. Don't give yourself to pride when he comes to sin. When he comes to area of sin, never you stand as a man in the highest authority. Because confess, anybody can say whether you are a pastor, whether you are a priest, whether you are a pope. All need to confess. In the book of Acts chapter 3, verse 19, it says, repent therefore and be converted, that your sin may be blotted out, so that time of refreshing may come from the presence of the Lord. When you confess, refreshment of the Spirit comes. Confession will make your spirit. by your spirit, it will bring peace and also a contact between you and God. Is somebody hearing me?
Yes.
That's why David, he said in the book of Psalm 32 verse 5, he said, oh Lord, I acknowledge my sin unto thee. And he said, my iniquity have I not hide. My iniquity have I not hide. Meaning, David said, I will never hide my sin. Proverbs 28:13, he said, he who hide his sin, he who cover his sin, he shall not. But he that confess shall obtain
mercy.
Say confession.
Confession.
Confess. Number two keys that will help you to experience new beginning of February. You must have the knowledge of redemption and hold on to it. You must have the knowledge of what? Redemption. You have been redeemed from the curse of war. You have been redeemed from the yoke of darkness. You have been redeemed from sin. You have been redeemed from anything that will hold you back. Many does not have this knowledge. Just now I talk about confession. Confession is just only to let God know that you have done wrong. That's what. You know, sometimes when we are having Holy Communion, some of you don't take Holy Communion because you still feel like you are still a sinner. You see how you are holding yourself? You are still holding yourself in the bondage. Some people are still calling themselves, I am a sinner. I cannot partake this because I am a sinner. That is how you will remain sinner till the day that a trumpet will do all. Under the control, under the law of sin, under control of sin, you are no more there. Even though you sin against God, yet sin does not have control over your life. Why? Because you are being redeemed. Galatians 3:13, it says, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, verse 14. Verse 14 says that the blessings of Abraham might come on the Gentiles through Jesus, right? That we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith. Through faith. You'll be redeemed. You cannot be yoked anymore because Christ has set you free. He has made way for you. He become cursed that truly that you will not be under the yoke of course. But today, Christians are still having the knowledge that yet they still remain under the control of affliction. And that's why sin continues to rule and control. If you made a mistake, all you need to do is just confess. By faith! And proclaim the righteousness of Jesus Christ. Ask God to improve the righteousness of Jesus Christ upon your life because you have accepted Him as your Lord and personal Savior. So Christ is in you, and Christ is holy. He is pure. And if Christ dwells in you, you also, you are holy, you are all, you are pure. Colossians 1:13, he says, to 14, he says, He has delivered us from the power of darkness and conveyed us unto the kingdom of the Son of His love. Verse 14, he said, in whom we have redemption through His blood and the forgiveness of what? Of sin. Christ, He has made you free. Jesus has made you waver. He has paid the price of your sin. Anything you do today is just a mistake, is just an error. You just confess it out. That's all. And because of lack of knowledge of who you are in Christ, that is why majority of you still remain in bondage. Because you still thinking that you are still a sinner and controlled by sin. You are still thinking that devil, demon, demons, darkness, they are still controlling your life. You know, how can somebody say that your own fellow human being, God created witch, the woman or the man who says he's a witch, is the same God that yourself created him, true or not? And the same God that created him, true or not? He was created by God, and you too were created by God, and you have God living inside you, and yet you have fear of your own fellow human being. You are having fear that this man will kill you from within. This woman will kill you. This man is after you. This woman is after you. Why? You have been in that bondage because of the knowledge you have towards yourself. You don't know who you are. That's why when David, when he saw Goliath, Goliath was threatening the entire nation, an entire army of Israel. They were running away with fear and trembling. They were running away from the giant. Why? Because they don't know who they are. They don't know who God has made them to be. So now, and they were running away. David only came to supply food to their brothers in the military camp, in the field. He just came to supply. He only had the sound voice of the royal. David noticed that this voice is a counterfeit voice. David noticed that this voice is what? A counterfeit. This is a fake voice. This is not what God says. It's not what God is saying concerning the entire Israel. This voice is not of God. This voice is a voice from the pit of hell. And David replied, he said, who is this man that is uncircumcised? Who is this uncircumcised being? You see the reply of David? Meaning that all the sound of Goliath is fake. David knew that's not what God says. David knew that voice is contrary to what God says concerning the entire nation of Israel. And that's why David had a boldness. He said, let me fight this man, for I know that he that is in me is bigger than him. I know that he that is in me is bigger than he that is in me. You see, this is how we have been deceived. This is how enemies keep on tormenting our life, and we keep on struggling in bondage. I pray you will discover who you are. Someone here, you will discover. Say no. Have you ever wanted to ask yourself a question? What has God spoken concerning me? What has God spoken concerning me? The Bible says in the book of 1 Chronicles, chapter 4, verse 9 to 10. Jabez, listen to me carefully. Jabez will wake up one day. Jabez calculated and said, yes, I came from a woman that suffered from village. I came from the lineage of poverty. My mother, my father, they are suffering. But I search my Bible. My Bible tells me that I am what God says I am. Praise the Lord. My Bible tells me in Jeremiah 29:11 that the plan of God and the thought of God is not of evil. It's not to make me poor. It's not to make me suffer in pain. The man began. Jabez, he began to cite the scripture. He said, it's an error. My family has given me a wrong label by giving me the name Jabez. Community has given me a label because my family, they are poor. But the Lord says, I am not poor. The Lord says, I am not going to suffer. The Lord says, I am not going to go through this journey of wilderness. That is the voice of God. Now, there were four voices speaking against him. That voice from home. Your family is poor. Your mama is poor. Your mama is suffering. And he gives you this name, that's why you are suffering. So you need to inherit. What is happening in your family? Tell me something. It's not what God says. Church, it is time for you to realize this. It is time for you to know that what God says concerns you is not what people say concerns you. What people are saying concerns you is not what God has said concerns you. What God says concerns you is different from what people are saying concerns you. Only you to realize it. Suffering does not glorify God. Disappointment does not glorify God. Failure does not glorify God. What glorifies God is blessing, manifestation, and His money. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Realize yourself. Don't you ever say, realize yourself. Realize who you are. Say, know who you are. And Jabez began to speak into his heart. He said, from this moment, enough is enough for suffering. Enough is enough for disappointment. Enough is enough of pain. Enough is enough. And that ended. The Bible says, God heard him and God blessed him. Praise the Lord. God heard him and what? Yes. He said, God will intervene. He said, God will bless you. Isaiah 62, your name shall no more going to be called pains. Your name shall become fruitful.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nobody God has limited. God never limited anyone. God never said any man will suffer and cry or will die. It's not an agenda. It is an agenda from the Lord. If you are suffering, it is time to change his way. Are you with me?
Yes,
it is time to know to change the story through your mindset by discovering who you are, by knowing who you are. Micah 7 verse 19. He said, he will again have compassion on you. He said, he will subdue our iniquity. He said, you will cast all sins into the depth of the sea. Praise the Lord. Number three. Is it number three?
Yes.
Number three keys that will help you to experience new beginning. Daily renewal of your mind. Daily renewal of your mind. New mindset will always attract new things. Is somebody listening to me? Listen carefully. A new thinking, new mindset, there is every tendency that you will experience new things. New thinking will always bring the new thing. But old thinking will still bring the old things. And the old things will always keep you in bondage. The new things will always elevate you, increase, and bring growth. Because when you are experiencing new things every day, you are growing. But when you are still experiencing old things, you still remain in the circle. You still remain in the one place. So now you need to renew your mind. That's why in the book of Ezekiel, chapter 36, verse 26, he said, I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit within you. He said, I will take the heart of the stone out of your flesh and give you a heart of flesh. He's talking about giving a new heart. Why would God do that? God wants to give the new heart and new spirit so that new blessings and new things will begin to do what? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Romans 12 verse 2. Romans 12 verse 2.
He said, and do not be conformed
to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind. By the renewal of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Do not conform, do not think the way the world thinks. Do not think the way others think. You are different, think different. Ask the Lord to bring new ideas, new thoughts in your mind. Praise God. Those who are walking in 2 o'clock, our church is 10 o'clock, not 3 o'clock. Praise the Lord. 1 Peter verse 1 to 14. He said, as obedient children, not conforming yourself to the former lust as in your ignorance. Listen up. He said, as in your ignorance, meaning something that you don't know and have been in bondage with. He said, not conforming yourself to the former lust as in your ignorance. What is your lust? Your lust is the area of your life that is worldly. Worldly things. Worldly activities. And when your heart is accumulated with things that is worldly, you discover that there is no way you can experience the blessings of God. Number four, you will desire for a move forward. Desire for a move forward. Every day in your daily basis, desire for a move forward. When you wake up in the morning, speak to yourself. Say, I am moving forward today. I am moving forward. You see, that is how it shall be. People don't know how to speak positive things to their life. Desire moving forward, not backward. Don't hang around with those that kill destiny and rob destinies. Don't hang around with those who always tell you old stories. Always desire a moving forward. A moving forward. When I mean desire, let it be your hunger. Let it be your appetite. I am moving forward. I am not going backward. Even though the economy of the nation, even though the status and the law of the nation is changing, even though things are going contrary in the nation, always be positive to your life and say, I am moving
forward.
I am going
forward.
Philippians 3, verse 13. He said, brethren, I do not count myself to have apprehended, but one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind. Which are what? Behind. And reaching forward to those things which are ahead. You see how Paul was speaking here? He said, his desire is to forget those things behind, the past things. And another is desire again to pursue the things in the front, to set his mind on things forward. Every child of God needs to think front. Remember, life is going front. Life is not going backward. If today now end, it has end. You will not see today again. You only see tomorrow. So now, if you only see tomorrow, expect something tomorrow, not yesterday. Desire moving forward. Desire going forward. Desire going higher. Forget about what happened yesterday. Somebody hurt you yesterday. Forget about it. Somebody cursed you yesterday. Forget about it. Somebody gossiped you yesterday. Forget about it. Somebody said all kind of vulnerable against you yesterday. Forget. Walk out. Forget it and do another one. Is someone listening to me? remembering the failure of the business. They wasted their time. Praise the Lord. They wasted their time. Wasted everything. Say, I am moving forward. I prophesy to you. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, number five keys. You must embrace the Holy Spirit in your daily lifestyle. Embrace the Holy Spirit in your daily
lifestyle.
Holy Spirit will guide you, He will lead you, He will help you because He's your helper. He will tell you what to do when you wake up and you are confused. Last week, I lost my phone. I find it everywhere, I couldn't find it. I said, God, this cannot happen to me. Because many people will say, I think that man is a serial. I didn't see where the phone is. I just asked God, I said, Father, I give that phone 24 hours to be discovered. After 2 days, I find it everywhere, I can't place it. I said, I command the angels now to go and bring that phone. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I just slept off. When I slept off, revelation came. Bam. Where is Chima? I saw Chima. Chima was counting the money. I looked to myself, this money you are counting is my money. I lost it. And I'm looking for it. Yeah, I saw it. Then I said, you know, if you're a prophet, is it? Every revelation God gives to you has a meaning. Money speaks for back. Then when I saw the revelation, I said, what is this? And the Holy Spirit said, you remember you went to the bank so day. That was where you locked the phone. Praise the Lord. And I went to the bank immediately. In the morning, I went to the bank. I read the bank and said, I lost the phone, J6 Samsung. They say, yes, he's dead. They give it to him. He will show you things that doubt your
evidence.
He will show you hidden things. He will say it to you and tell you this is it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
My wife was surprised. I said, yeah. I woke up, I thought, I said, my phone is in the back. That's what God says. He said, how do you know? I said, just watch. And I came back with it. Say, God is faithful. Say, God is faithful. Say, God in Romans 8:13-14. He said, for if you live according to the flesh, he said, you will die. But if you live by the Spirit, you put to death the deed of the body. He said, you will live. It is the Holy Spirit that helps us to live and survive. When you have the Holy Spirit, sickness will not near you. Dangers will not come. Before they come, He will reveal to you. He will say to you, this morning God showed me a brother that was apprehended this morning. And I prayed for you. I said, my brother, see what I saw. And this is going to happen between man and ladies. Praise the Lord. That's the work of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit reveals secrets. He shows you things that you don't know. Especially when it acts. Or when it is active in your life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You must embrace Him. The last that we are going to deal with, the last key is daily word declaration of favor upon your life. You must declare favor upon your life on a daily basis. Anywhere you see yourself, I am favored. When you wake up in the morning, I am what? When you want to do a business, I am what? Even though it's not coming for, continue to declare declare it until it begins to happen. Because that's what God says. You see, the God said it and that settles it. I believe it and that settles it. You see, God said I am blessed. God said I am favored. God said I am lifted. And I believe it and that settles it. When you went to sleep, God said I am blessed. God said I am favored. And I believe it and that settles it. When you wake up, God said I am blessed. God said I am favored. And I believe it and that settles it. You love it.
Hallelujah.
Are you blessed with the word of God?
Yes, sir.
This one, you know, I'm making noise. Are you offended?
No, I don't know.
Place your hand on your head. Say, my father, my father. I declare new beginning upon my life today. From the day, I begin to manifest. Everything that concerns me begin to bear fruit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father.
Thank you. Amen. Prematurely in the name of Jesus. They shall be heads they are not detained even in the midst of their colleagues.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ, no sickness shall come their way.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name. Because of these children, blessings financially shall come to their family. They shall attract favor. They shall not bring shame to the family. But they shall excel in life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I cover them with the blood of Jesus. I cover their parents with the blood of Jesus Christ. They shall continue to celebrate, and God is going to bless them more in the future in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Happy birthday in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Clap your hands for Master Jesus.
Desire this week, you shall have them all. In the name of Jesus, the Lord shall be a wall of fire that will surround your life. Anywhere you go, your guardian angel will lead you. Your angel will always show you the way. In the name of Jesus, close your eyes, for I pray for each and every one here. I bless you under the hand of the Lord Almighty.
Amen.
May the hand of the Lord be upon you.
Amen.
Father, I cancel death.
Amen.
Anyone here that spirit of death is following, it is cancelled in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is cancelled in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is cancelled in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And Lord, I pray that you are children. Nobody here will cry.
Amen.
We have declared, and that settles it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I will call on one of our pastors here, Pastor Pakistan, to come and give us a short prayer for closing prayer.
Thank you, Pastor. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. This blessing, every people give your offering. You give that more blessing. Open the sky and give it your everybody blessing. My Father, this week in the name of glory, Jesus. Heaven, Father, heaven, Jesus. You give everybody, you give the power, blessing, increase the business, increase the world, everybody. Thank you, Father.
Amen.
Amen.
May the Lord be with you, and may the Lord go with you. May God and the Spirit of the Most High God stay with you.
Amen.
In your houses, may the Holy Spirit dwell with you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For I cover all your children by the blood of Jesus.
Jesus,
I cover your family by the blood of Jesus.
Jesus,
as you go, may you go in peace.
Amen.
May you begin to experience manifestation of
Amen.
Grace will walk at this point. Mercies of God will speak for you. All the days of your life,
Amen.
You will dwell in mercy.
Amen.
From today, beginning of new settlement in your life,
Amen.
Everything concerns will become new today.
Amen.
Everything that bearing your name, begins to experience the glory of God.
Amen.
Father God, as this month has been declared month of settlement, you shall experience it.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and his fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and surely the preservation of us all the days of our life, and we shall be blessed of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
You are blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.